So let's have a look back at the action here in Azerbaijan. On the way down to the first corner, everyone pretty much behaved themselves and kept, to a certain extent, their grid order. Andy Sucek managed to get up into fourth place, getting past Frederik Vervisch. But apart from that, everyone else was safely through. But then it all kicked off here. Joe Osborne threw it down the inside, made contact with the Mercedes, which then made contact with another Mercedes. And the end result was Dominic Baumann in the concrete, unfortunately. And let's have another look at that. There was Osborne making the contact, and then just out of shot for the left-hand side, they all ended up in the barriers. There was also a moment for Mateusz Stump, who was spun around at the top of the circuit, and he had to retire after that particular incident a little bit later on once the race got going again. So turn seven, not a happy hunting ground. This was a key moment in the race. Maximilian Buch losing majority of his rear wing by tapping the wall on the outside. Zanardi lost most of his front end after being pushed into the wall by Alvaro Parent down at the hairpin.
The car has still actually been driven. I mean, you can see he's trying to grab clutch because the car is still unthrottled and is pushing its way just to the end. Here's the pit stop. And three quarters of the rear wing on the car did make it difficult for Maximilian Gutz when he went back out. But the damage had been done. Consolidated finished in the end in that ninth place. And everything worked in their favour ultimately.
There were some of the race leaders lapping the back markers. And that in the end cost them as your own Bleekemolen and Harry Prochek emerged in the lead of the race. How things change in motor racing. And look, the car looks pretty secure there as they lost the lead to Cesar Ramos. And they were still looking pretty comfortable in that second position, and Johnny Adam was starting to make his way up the order, but then Max Gertz, with all that loss of downforce, started to slide back through the field, and there he lost out to the Porsche of Martin Raginger, who then went around the outside of Chris Vanderdrift at the left-hander up towards the right-hand turn, but then it all started to break away for the Lamborghini.
Yes, I mean, it's just shedding bodywork, literally. They went into the pits and all they could do was put tape on it, but by which time everything had gone. A little bit of contact towards the end of the race, the Corvette sliding by the Mercedes.
Oh, and there was a big spin then, so we didn't see that, but it was the win for Cesar Ramos and Laurens Vanthoor. Johnny Adam finished second, but Maximilian Gertz took victory and the Blancpain Sprint Series title. He will be racing again in the main race later on. Make sure you join us.